Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It is the one, the only, the Azothan, and we are going to be playing, casting a game called War in the Plaguelands, an amazing spawn-based map, much akin to the types of maps such as, just seeing this, I already know the absolute hell that's about to go down. And I apologize ahead of time for the slight mist that hangs over everything. We may zoom in close to the end of the game. I have no fucking idea how long it is, but this is the premise. It's 6-on-6. It's the Crusade versus the crazy, absolute, over-the-top, undead presence in the area of the Eastern Kingdoms. Around about, during the Third War, a little bit before, a little bit after. It's kind of hard to tell where this is set exactly in the timeline. If you know, feel free to put it in the comments. But this is what we're doing today. We're going to be doing the Darkest Month, and this certainly qualifies as a dark map, guys. It's this shady, cloudy, everything's almost dead. There's no hope left. The last bastions of humans stand. These little tiny things against the overwhelming. Let's go ahead and see if we can find one of the bad guys here. Ordo? Yeah, look at that. They cover everything. The world is theirs for the taking. They control most of Stratholme. Everything benefits them, and now we're gonna watch as the hopeless human survivors attempt to do their best to hold in there. And let's go ahead and start the game. I'm feeling good, it's gonna be dark and dangerous. Plague worms, and the cool thing about spawn-based maps is they have the ability to put in interesting creatures that can't be abused because you can't decide how many of them you get. You'd be like, you can only have one at a time. You can't figure out a way around that, you can't mess with it. You know, and you gotta use it appropriately, because it could just die and you'll never get another one. You can't reproduce it. Spawn-based maps are tough, and they really, really make you think about how you use your units. Because if you can be as effective as possible, you have a great advantage. Kill more units than you lose, you're in a good spot. Other games, is if you play sneaky and do other stuff, you know, oh, you just spam tons and tons of units, can't do that. Blue says, I thought I was purple, meaning he's probably a little confused, a little put off at the moment. Towers are tough in here because they shoot up with like 6 units at a time. You can see them just shooting out tons of little beams there. So that's really more like 150 damage every time it shoots its little beam of death out. And Pink's not going to take that lying down. The Plague Specialists come to attack the Talon Forgerings. Again, I don't know the names of all this stuff, guys. I'm as lost as you are. Vietnam. As one time in Nam, I was in my friend Nam. And it got awkward. Scarlet Monastery, okay. And this is going to be jam-packed in the beginning, guys, so don't be surprised if it's a little odd, a little hectic, fast-paced, over the top. Great thing about spawn-based maps is they don't tend to go on for that long, either. I thought it said John and Azathan. I was like, oh, best name! We can see Red here trying his best to hold on to this choke point. He knows it gives him the advantage because this guard tower, three guard towers were shooting tons of spikes into Orange's army. Fortunately for Red, it looks like Orange is just a bit more well put together at the moment. All these tiny spawns of skeletons and zombies mean that they can soak up more attacks from those towers without... Oh, look at the skin on that zombie, guys. Holy shit. That thing looks like it belongs in Skyrim, not Warcraft 3. Holy hell. And it looks like Teal's trying to push out, but what will be the response? Oh, God. Purple's rushing down here to try to deal with it. So many pings going on the map. No one knows what's going on. All right. Purple is a good guy. I've established that. So purple is fighting off dark green and yellow. Teal doing a very good job. I think he got Ramstein there. Oh no! Ramstein did the charge you! He cannot die! Oh, Gluth. Gluth died once and now he dies twice, meaning Gluth is permanently out of the game. GG for him. Blue says GG. I didn't want to play blue anyways. Bye. They're like, dude, don't leave. Light Blue is like, oh, fuck me, more whiny people. That's the hardest thing about these games, is people just throw fits when they don't get what they want. Also, weirdly enough, I need to figure out what's up with my voice. I need to get a lozenge or something, because believe it or not, I'm a little tired already from talking, and normally I can go quite a bit longer than this. Oh, Black Templars trying to focus down Marjan, not going to work out too well for him. Not enough on the ground here to do that damage. As you can see, it's an absolute bull rush to see who's going to win. Orange petering out in his attacks right here, but he's taken so much ground. He's managed to build spirit towers. He will take out the Festival Lanes Hall. Outpost being built up right now by Red. He's desperately hoping this is going to hold on. This will give him more spawns because he's going to need them once Festival Lanes falls. Orange is not giving up, and Kel'Thuzad at level 8, that dwarfing the three units, the three heroes here for red. Two, possibly. Oh, he's got three. One, two, three. Ah, yellow's being collapsed in upon right now by the forces. Man, it's so hard to see who's who. Yeah, what do you think? Should we zoom in? It's not gonna be that long of a game. We can just make this a one-parter zoomed in. Oh, we're gonna watch the destruction from up close. The gates will be held. Purple's trying to break in on blue. Did blue leave? Yes, he left because he's a bitch. Sorry, Vietnam, but this one time in Nam, he was a bitch. Scarlet Temple is doing a very good job of holding this gate. Purple's going to throw a lot of units at it for no good. And that looks like a special elite ghoul. I was going to say, it looked a little bit more special than your normal average everyday ghoul. My god, orange just flooding with units near constantly. Alright, Light Blue says, I fold. I fucking failed. I have no idea what he failed at. Alright, so teams are even again. White goes down. Oh, it's, that's such a good skin. Look at the skins in this game. They're really pretty. Reinforcements have arrived. Green saying pathetic. He doesn't deserve to be one of us if he can't handle it like a man. Alright, Orange now officially has control. God, everything looks very different close up. It's like, it's more personal. I can go ahead and, oh, look. Oh, no. Defend against the undead. Ah, there's no good angles there. Fuck it. There might be good angles here. Oh, no. The Unholy Death Knights are running straight in. They're hero aiming. They're trying to get down Sadie and Dothrohan. They know if they take them out. Oh, the hero's gone. And the belt of the Grand Crusader does go to Demetria, but she's going to fall too here in a second. Orange just doesn't even care. Look at him just hero aiming like it doesn't even matter. Oh, I think that's going to be Red saying GG there. That was... oh, that hurts so much to watch. That's not a heal, says Red. No, indeed. You were not getting healed. You were getting bone. Is Pink... yeah, Pink broke into here, finally destroyed Blue's defenses, and this leads to Tears Fall Pass. And Red saying he's done. Yeah, I gotta say, he got handled pretty early. He didn't have any help coming from his allies. His allies are doing a good job down south. Of course, I don't know about Dark Green. And Fraps, being a bitch, hold on. All right, Frapsy Poo, I need you to behave yourself. 10, no, it's not enough frames per second for me, baby. I need more out of you, and you know it. Okay, now, are we friends again? Oh, you're sitting at 60 FP. You moved, and things broke. 10 is not good, damn. Maybe this time. It's like a crapshoot each time. It's like, ah, maybe it'll work. Maybe it won't. Yodel-hee-hoo. I'll deal with you. I want to be like you. Can't you see? Oh, it was sitting at 60 there for a while. I wonder what caused it to change. I don't know. I would have been fine with 60 FPS. That would have been great. I'll tell you what I can't deal with. 5. 5 is no bueno. I can make my peace with, I don't know, 20? 20 be fine. Zero's no bueno, though. God, this must get annoying to you guys after a while. Look, 30. Perfectly fine. Hit the pause button. Oh, still 30. Perfectly fine. Okay, I think the game has decided to be okay with me now. Man, I had to promise to wine it, dine it, 69 it again, but it's worth it if it'll just run appropriately. I do like the Russian roulette nature of this, where it's like, is it gonna work or am I gonna look like an ass? Oh my god. God, is this all people I know again? Samil, Ordo. No, just Samil and Ordo. Thanks for sending me in this game, guys. War in the Plaguelands, kicking butt. Ziggurat of the Fungal Veil. These things are it's just a death. Oh, it's a death trap. Look how many beams of awfulness are hitting him at all times. Oh god, this would be the horrible place to try to make a last stand. Or just a phenomenal place, one way, whether you're attacking or defending, really changes how you're going to view this game. But I lost all heroes, that's true, he lost all his heroes, but he's still technically alive. You could try to make a stand on the Crimson Throne. Oh, Blue suicided all his heroes, what a dick. Hearthglen outpost. Ignore my voice dying, guys, and cracking. I swear it's not all as bad as you think. Now, that did fall. Oh, shit. Or did it? No, actually, this little bit of area is still alive. The outpost is being built up right now, and just a few Scarlet Crusaders and Knights might be able to hold this off. Pink swarming around. Dark Green's got a ton of units at this. Oh, it's going to be really tough to break that. And no defense on this bridge means Yellow and Teal get to run across the bridge and defend their poor erstwhile allies who have been hard-pressed this entire time with a player who left. That's a cool building animation right there. Oh, this thing looks like the... Actually, it looks a bit like the cathedral from Diablo 2. Or Diablo 1, I should say. Sorry, those everybody who thought I was wrong. Oh, God. Oh, and Holy Death Knight's getting caught out of position. Scarlet Knight's rushing to the fence. Durgan, the Scarlet Cavalier, says, fuck off! I've got plenty of knights at my back. At me back. And Fraps doesn't have me back. Let's play Russian roulette again, guys. I swear to God. That's the next thing I'm using. For anyone who ever decides that they're going to contribute to the channel, the next thing I buy for the channel is going to be an actually halfway decent thing for recording, because Fraps is not doing it. Are we good? We're at 60 FPS. If it behaves itself, that's great. The minute we look at anything, the game says, all right, 45. 45 is good. 30 is even better. Woo, keep giving me 30, honey. No, not 10, not 4. What's wrong with you, Fraps, you weak... Function properly, Fraps. All right, maybe if I start it up while the game's running and not paused, it'll be better able to deal with what's going on. I don't know. I don't know what caused it. Those are human heads. Those are masks. Heads floating. Oh, I didn't even know. Is that what that's always looked like? That's terrible. They're saying no aims. I see no aim. Okay, aiming is kind of frowned upon in this game, even though Orange did it hardcore. He's got to move his units out of that death and decay. It's just wrecking everything. Kel'Thuzad laughing his ass off. He's like, yeah, sit there and die, warriors, you silly bitches. And by the time his units even get to those guys, they're already dead from death and decay. Yellow's going to keep stampeding through the withering, the lands, whatever you want to call it, in the hopes that he can probably take some pressure off of Dark Green over here. Because Dark Green is, he's alone, dude. Yeah, actually, I think, let's go ahead and... Oh, man, Dark Green is alone over in the south. And Light Blue is kind of making a comeback. Of course, Samil now with his units getting a good... Oh, he's about to get an excellent concave. He's about to squish in between two big armies. Nowhere for him to run. He's going to lose everything in this army. Light Blue... Luckily, Light Blue is the one that left. His units are just being used as fodder, essentially. Should I place all my barracks things on my big thingy? Inigo Montoy was slain. Oh! Says, nobody cares. Just attack, Dark Green. Attack something. Cake a base. Kill it. Destroy it. I don't know. You've got so many units sitting there. He's like, nah. Not gonna attack. I'm just gonna build up and defend. What kind of a noob attacks? Oh, Yellow's under attack, guys. Let's go check it out. It's just a few stray undead units. No reason for alarm. Red saying, dude, you have so much stuff. Loxie, the Houndmaster. Wow, Petey Boys using my curse words for Fraps against other people. Okay, that's fine. I can't really complain. Malvinius, the Cauldron Lord. And who are the other heroes here? Dark Reaver. I think he's trying to act like Soul Reaver, but he's not a cool Soul. Soul Reaver would kill every single unit and hero on this map in one... He just by himself. Those five heroes could destroy everything in this game like nothing. No, I'm taking Blue's units here, noob. Why, it's me since you suck. Oh! Alright, so Blue... Red's now using Blue. And he's using all of Blue's units to attack. Shut the fuck. You lost. You suck. Oh my god. Man, they're just hating on each other so hardcore. Meanwhile, Orange destroying the rest of what was left of Red. Teal kind of owns up here, guys. Joseph Redpath. Oh, man, look at these skins, guys. They're so good. Those Scarlet Templars with their hammer. Oh, they've even got, like, eagles on the back of their hammers or lions. I don't care. Either one is awesome. And purple doesn't have anything to worry about. Man, it's so dark and foggy and everything's so... Actually, if I'm following this correctly, this is a very good representation of what it looks like in the Plaguelands leading up to Stratholm. Good job to the Terrainers. I'm not even looking at their argument anymore. I don't give a fuck. Dark Green is fighting and losing his Scarlet Knights. He's doing an okay job holding everything off, but unless Master Gambling falls, why do the undead have heals? Oh, holy light, bless me with the power to be able to save my undead brethren in the name of the light. Ordo at this point is like, just shut the fuck up, both of you. Alright, Teal's going for a big push, but I think Green's had enough, or Green is just going to suicide all of his units thinking that he's helping, and in actuality, he's just dying. Samil and Ordo holding it down over here in the east. Woo! East side representing. And now Blue and Dark Green's units all ran into a wall. Dark Green, his units are all out there. That's good. And he's winning, technically. He's not losing, but where are his heroes? There they are, in the back. Herod, the Armory Lord. Man, I love his shoulders. Does he have the right shoulders? He needs them. I know they exist. I think the footmen are wearing more closely Herod shoulders than he is. Damn, Dark Green, it does end up losing this outpost. That's a bit of a resource sink there, unfortunately. But he should be able to recover, while my fraps should not. Bugger it all! You wee Tweety bird bucket basket bastard. I wish there was a hotkey for pausing this, because it's hard at 1 frame per second to get the pause button. Very difficult. There we go. Come on, pause. Oh, guys, I just don't know what I'm going to do if Fraps keeps doing this. It's crazy. Maybe that's what I'll ask for my birthday. It's coming up on November 15th. I'm going to be 25 years old, guys. 25. I'm an old bastard. I'm a quarter of a century old, as my dad put it, and it just freaks me out. But maybe I'll be like, Mom, Dad, I'm doing so well in college. Do you think maybe you could, Maybe, just maybe. Or I'll just use whatever birthday money. They want to take me to Vegas. Honestly, I'd rather have better equipment than a Vegas trip. As weird as that sounds, I am one of the few people in the world who's like, I'd rather not go to Vegas. I'd rather have better stuff for my computer so I can deliver better stuff for my subscribers. Oh, Yellow's like, I'm so out of position. Run, Darien, run. Oh, he's slowed. He's cursed. They're aiming hard. They want the son of Alexandros. But they can't have him. Oh, thank God he got out of there. It was frighteningly close. Argent War Mages. See, they can just create weird things that don't make sense. Argent Dawn Archers. For no reason. Just women with super gray straw hair. And it looks awesome. No, says Red. No. You can't have this last build plot. Tis mine. Oh, shit. Red's actually got some stuff. Oh, what? He's got Malor the Zealous. Yes, says Dark Green. Yes. Why go? Yes, go. All right, well, Red, get your shit in there. You were telling him to attack and grow some balls, and now you're not doing anything, Brosif. Lose many units on the towers. Yes, he probably will, but if he can crush this, it's done with. But Red decides to be a twunt. Actually, I think they're all jerks at this point. I haven't seen a single person where I'm like, I agree with that lad. He seems like a reasonable sort. My suspicion is this will be a two-parter. Our allies are under attack? No, surely not. If Red was here, this would be dead already. Completely dead. But now reinforcements are going to arrive. Plague specialists, zombies, things of that sort. Fairbanks and the dwarves have finally arrived in Tyr's hand. To aid Mograine. Mograine gives the dwarves a home in the Scarlet Keep. What? Where's that? Is it here? Oh, what the fuck? Argent Dawn Torin? All the races have joined the Argent Dawn. It's not just one peoples now. It's all the peoples. Where did he give them a home, though? Because this is Tyr's hand, right? Okay, so he gave the dwarves a home. Is it the brewery? That would make a lot of sense. Oh, laddie, we just came here to sit in our asses and drink beer. And I'm all out of beer. We came out of kick-ass and chew bubblegum. And I'm all out of... Oh, he's going to take out Dalsin's Tears. Another Plague Cauldron goes down. Cardero, very safe. Skolomant's not going down. The Houndmasters... No, all of Dark Green's heroes are dead. Because Red left him to die. Yeah, I like how Red's like I said, man, you were going to lose... GG. Jesus. Yeah, it's not over, man. He's still got two heroes. He's still okay. Man, these two don't like each other. They're like two dogs that sniffed each other's asses and they forgot to wipe, so now they're just super angry. Alright, now we have people telling other people to cry. We have Gray running around with his hero squad, Eraj the summoner. How many heroes does he have? Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2 Death Knights. 5. 5 heroes and 2 Death Knights. Come on, grab Kirtanos, the herald. Before he turns into a gargoyle and flies away. No, you have nothing? Okay, cool. Need help, says Purple. Does he need help? What's he doing? Ordo. Oh, I forgot about Purple. I forgot Purple was even a thing. Even though it's Samil, and he's awesome. Hasn't lost any heroes yet, as far as I know. Uh-oh. Thaddeus has been unleashed on all those who would oppose the Scourge. Thad, bro. Oh, did Thad just leave outside? Let's go see if he's outside. Thaddeus, bro. Nope. Plague Eruptors. Oh, those things are ugly! Where were you? Dealing with something ugly! Those who haven't seen the Disney version of the Three Musketeers, you are missing out so hard. It is one of the best movies ever. And, oh, so good. Charlie Sheen, when he was still very young and very attractive and just super charming. Oh, no. Yellow, teal, and purple are about to collapse in on this army. Does Orange have what it takes? He's got so many units. He's got Thaddeus. He's got crazy numbers of heroes here. But can he take this fight from all angles? Anubra Khan, undoubtedly going to be one of the first ones to fall. Horgus as well. Oh, fuck you, Horgus. I killed you in the original WoW. I went through that long, involved, ridiculous quest line to beat you. And I did it, son. Oh, looks like Purple might want to engage directly with this army. But Orange backs out. No, he's not feeling it. Even though Kel'Thuzad is level 12, he just can't stomach the idea of potentially losing him. Because that would indeed be a GG. Kel'Thuzad is a game changer, but he has to be in the right position. No point wasting him too early on. We have an entire group of Aragorns down here, otherwise known as the Argent Crusaders. And, well, oh my, a few abominations here felt like duking it out in the streets. They're like, nah, man, it's cool. I just want to fight. Argent Dontorin, so strong, so much health. And up here, how's Red holding? He's got Bastion's encampment. He's, oh shit. Oh, he's probably going to lose all of his units here to some hero aiming. Renault and Walden have to run. Scarlet Rangers, well, it's a very close fight up here. And I need some delicious raisins covered in. Oh, yeah, so good. Mmm, delicious. Orange, run. Run your unholy Death Knight prick ass away. Why do I always root for the good guys? Because I can't help it. I was never Horde. I was never Chaos in Warhammer. It's for the Emperor, bros, for the Alliance, for everything. That's how I roll, sorry. And for those of you guys who are like, oh, whatever. It's not because I want to be cool, it's because I genuinely cannot do bad things in video games. It makes me feel like a horrible person. I play Skyrim as the most lawful good thing you'll ever see. I don't steal, I don't kill citizens. I'm boring, that's why I don't do those Let's Plays. There was a game all about being a holy, awesome crusader. But then at the same time, I don't like lawful good. I'm very chaotic good. I do what I think is right, but I always do what I think is right. I'm never like, oh, I just want some free gold. I'm going to murder a child. No, I can't do it. But if that child's going to turn into Satan, maybe I'll kill the child. Maybe. They're getting to a gray area there. An Orange, he's back with a vengeance. He's upset. This is a giant army of the light here. So strong, so good. And now they realize, hey, we still have blue units here that we can throw away at things randomly. They better be attacking from a second front. Guys, you have to attack here while you're distracting them with this over here. Come on. Here, here. You can't, don't throw your whole army at one spot. Throw two armies at two spots while they have one army dying. Holy crap, this is a lot of fighting going on. Can we get any other angles on it? No, it's nothing. It's just confusion and glowy lights. Ugh. Can you imagine being in this brawl? I mean, being in a regular fight would be confusing enough. Being in this fight, it's just, oh, my eyes are filled with green stuff. Oh, is that guy glowing? What the fuck? There's runes above his head. Oh, God, flashes of light. I know you're healing me, but I can't see anything. Holy shit. And what? And why is Alexandros Mograine wearing three mithril helmets? He triple bagged it, guys. He took the always used protection to its, like, just way too far. Oh my god. I don't know what that was, but I get the feeling it was very strong. There was a lot of light. And that, too. The whole army should have, like, a 75% miss chance after that. Oh, my retinas! You burned them out, you fucker! How am I supposed to fight with Alexandros Light, Flash, and Mograine? Alexandros the... Oh, god damn it. Are they not attacking still? Jesus. Alexandros the Rave Mograine is what he's known amongst his friends as. Red's like, hey, you've got Scarlet Knights. Why don't you use them? I had to show my girlfriend Skeksis the other day. And, no, I said Skeksis is in the Dark Crystal. And you... I hope you guys have seen that. And the reason was, I think she made this noise. In response to the dog being cute, but immediately made me think of that, like one that constantly whimpers in the dark. And then I had to show her and I realized that I thought it was all Skeksis. He's the only one that does that in the whole game. The whole game. The whole movie. Just one of them has a weird tick. And make. There we go, that was it. Almost like I saw a fine booty. And that concludes our minute and a half of Azathan making weird noises for no reason. Alright, Ordo's feeling feisty-ish. Oh, this is not looking good. Their armies are getting torn apart. They've got to get in there. They've got to do some serious damage or else these Argent War Mages are so good. Oh, they destroy abominations. And we have kind of a ceasefire over here. There's lots of units, lots of armies, things moving around, but nothing's happening. And they've got to attack from all directions for this to be effective. I think Red's going to back out and be like, "No. Why would I attack? Oh, you're so dumb. Oh, you're gonna lose your units. It's my best impression, guys. That's all I've got. Look at that. He's just running Blue's army through a fucking... Ah, I want to hit him. Okay. Plague Eruptors getting in on the front lines, destroying shit. Purple is really the only thing holding. Yellow's got a great choke point over here. Wonderful. I don't know why he's backing out. Probably because he realized... And Dark Green saying IGG. He's probably saying I go. IGUG should be I go, you go. I go, you go. You go now. You're wasting time. Oh no, Elago Dawnbringer. Oh god, he's so close to die. You can see Orange. He's like, oh, I want it. I want it so bad. I bet he wants it. That dirty girl. And the ghouls destroy everything. Oh, they're parasites? Holy shit. That's frightening. And Yellow's trying to hold this. He's holding it down. Holy shit, lag, says Dark Green. That's... wow, now Red is like, huh, maybe now I should go after all his units are dead, and I'm not actually supporting anything, and I'm still not going to bring my hero in because I don't want to lose him. And then you ask yourself, what's the point of having a hero if you don't use them? The whole thing that sucks about losing a hero is that you can't use them anymore and they're so good. Is that, right, but if I don't use the hero, I can't lose the hero. Right, but if you're not using the hero, you might as well lose the hero. Nope, you don't understand, you don't understand. Listen here, laddie. If I don't use the hero, I can't lose the hero. God damn it. Fuck off, Pete boys. Oh my god, so much AoE damage, and now Kel'Thuzad is just raining the death down. Oh, it's so... Move all the units. It does so much damage. A Bendis with another Mithril helmet. Does everyone have Mithril helmets? Bridget Abendis. Albert Abendis. Oh, just Abendis. My name is Abendis Abendis. Oh no. Bridget! Bridget, no! Teal, run! No, they want it. They want wanted so bad. Okay, he's Shadow Melon. It's all safe now. It's all good in the hood, broskies. And now it's Evil's turn to attack. They were much more patient, meaning they're going to have more units at the end of this. And still a big army from Gray. He's got his hero squad. He's got things. Meanwhile, Blue has been wiped off the map. They should really send these units in. Oh, look at Red. He's like, I killed Skeleton. I technically used my hero. Aren't I such a good boy? Oh, you really are, Red. Just such a good boy. Holy crap, Scarlet Crossbowman. Pete Boys has units over here? What the fuck? And this looks like it's horrible for the undead to try to break through. Whereas they do have meat wagons. Holy shit. This is terrifying. This is one of the best choke points in the game I've ever seen. Oh, it's just death. It's in the background. You can see more and more streaming in. There's no hope of killing these things off before they're completely dead. And these are all infected with parasites, which means the moment they die, they're going to turn into ghouls. Lucky you. Leonid, Barthamuel, redeemed undead. Ambush. They are stuck. They are stuck. But there is a hero squad out there, and there's more hero squad, and lots of things all over the place. And purple's in his base, and teal's got no units. So yellow, yes, while they are stuck, they are still killing you. I don't argue your fact that they're stuck. I argue your fact that that's a bad thing for them. Waves, waves, skeleton. Man, those fucking skeleton models. Oh, they're so beautiful. Look at that thing. I don't know how it just winked or closed its eyebrow there. That's a little concerning. Oh, look. Now Red's like, maybe I'll use the... maybe I go ahead and I use the footmen, the mounted units now. Okay, maybe I go ahead and do that. That's fine. Alexandros Mograine's still alive, though. Purple has kept his units well and truly safe. And Yellow's actually holding this with good hero management. And a choke point, he's able to do this with towers behind him. Of course, if that spirit tower finishes, it's going to be a little annoying to try to break down. And once it's building, it's got 520 health while building. It's got significantly more when finished. It's going to finish. Now it's got 1500. Now your problem is three times as bad as it was. Oh, but they're still holding this. The Spirit Tower is going to finish, though. God, just aim it down. Just like five hits is way better than the 700 it's going to take you in a while. Oh, my God. The Undead Army just got massacred. They were flowing in from everywhere. And now Yellow, holding the gates, has managed to turn this around. There's such a big army packed in that small area right now. And they got to finish off that Spirit Tower before it finishes. And, okay. Hero Squad finishing that off. Let's go ahead and call that part one. This is going to be a two-parter. War of the Plaguelands part two coming out in just a little bit, bitch. That was just because I'm a Breaking Bad fan and I feel like I had Jesse Pinkman. As Jesse Pinkman would say, what now, bitch? Bitch? He's got a breathy bitch. What now, bitch? I just called all of you bitches five times. I'm so sorry. I love you all. I didn't mean it. Oh, God. I'll see you in part two if you still love me anymore. Bye.